Ninja, RMM partner used to seed ransomware. With great power comes great responsibility. We've heard that before, at least most of us nerds have. And this is true, of course, of the tools that we use to manage clients. Ninja RMM is a tool that I'm not deeply familiar with. It is a competing product to the ones we use. I've not heard anything really bad or good about it, but I'm positive they don't really like their name on a title unless it says protected against ransomware. And this comes to that: with great power, great responsibility. Ninja RMM said its tool was used to spread ransomware across multiple endpoints. And before you go into panic or the confusion that often comes with this wonderful headline, no, it's not a compromise in Ninja RMM. It's much less exciting. I don't have a clever hack to share with you. I don't have a, wow, this is amazing, this is a really interesting breach. It's actually kind of boring in terms of methodology. Methodology appears to be password guessing. And the folks at Huntress have, and I'll leave all this on Reddit, a good debrief on this. Essentially, what they appear to be happening here: people keep reusing passwords. And this is where I will blame Ninja, not for a security flaw in terms of a product flaw or a breach problem. It is a problem of they allow their users not to have 2FA. And if you can allow people to be lazy, they will. And unfortunately, this happens in the MSP space. And I've had conversations with Kyle, who's a CEO of Huntress, before. There just needs to be better methodologies to help audit these MSPs, to help, you know, prevent this from happening, because the ultimate victims are not the MSP, who, of course, may or may not even survive this type of thing, because now their clients are encrypted and their clients have now lost all trust in that MSP. So all the work they did in sales and everything else to build their client base now has a lot of angry client base. It all comes down to the MSP was lazy, did not have two-factor turned on, and that's what they discuss here. And they believe it was part of a compromise that happened somewhere else, perhaps somewhere else in the channel partner network, as in some company that you had to set a username and password up for it. Maybe not part of your tooling, maybe not part of what you use on a daily basis like Ninja RMM, but maybe some other site, and people go, yeah, whenever I use my work password, this is what I use, blah, 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 or some type of pattern for it, because the hackers are able to get in with valid credentials. And of course, without that second factor of authentication, it's kind of easy to get in. And Ninja RMM, by choosing convenience over security and saying, yeah, and we do fully support two-factor, Ninja RMM does. I was looking on their site, even though I haven't used it, they talk about all the different methodology of two-factor. They will also allow someone to not have it enabled. And I don't find this acceptable. This is my position on this. I think companies should force more people. I know it's inconvenient. I know there's a marketing team going, come on, we got to get this out there. We got to have sales. We can't have users complaining, oh, it's too hard to sign up, or it's too hard to use because I got to use this stupid little two-factor each time. That is a trade-off. You are dealing with a very powerful tool that allows remote management of lots of computers. The RMM tools that we use make it really easy to deploy software, deploy updates, manage computers at scale. So that same tool is quickly used against us if it is compromised and if you don't have two-factor. SolarWinds a while ago forced us to use two-factor, whether we liked it or not. I've been using two-factor forever with SolarWinds. It's not a policy I have at my company, top to bottom. But I know MSPs that do not. And it's really hard for businesses to make determinations on whether or not they have an MSP following the rules or not. And in reality, security is a team sport. My goal is to raise awareness. Hopefully, if you're in a position of power and you see something like this, you go, okay, it's time we do this. I realize we're not doing it and you do it. Or if you're not in a position to make decisions, you're hopefully going to share this video and influence someone, or share this article, share these write-ups and go, look, this is what happens to companies that choose convenience over security, potentially get compromised. Now, I highly recommend not just turning on two-factor, but not reusing passwords. This is one of the huge factors as well. And I know people, and I've dealt with this even when I've done some consulting with MSPs, I want to pull my hair out because I find out they're using the same password all over the place. And I'm just like, stop that. If any one of these places get compromised, they have keys to all of the kingdoms and all the different tooling that you use. So making sure you have unique passwords for everything is hugely important. Password managers can really help with that, because yes, passwords are hard to remember. That's why tools like LastPass and several others exist. So my advice is turn on two-factor, read through the debriefs if you want to know some of the details. There's also a link to a excellent YouTube video which is a breach breakdown report previously done by Huntress. It's an excellent watch. Go through that. It's a good learning lesson on there. But it's one of those things, like you need to be aware of these things. If you're working in the MSP space, I'm driven nuts by people who get into this because they go, oh, there's money in this technology thing. But then they make shortcuts of convenience. Don't do that. Please 2FA all day, every day. Don't make exceptions to that. We can't make it this easy for people to get in. And you know, you work really hard on sales. You really work hard on building your client base. I don't know the details. This MSP will remain anonymous, but they may not remain at all. They may end up going out of business because, trust me, their clients who are finding out that they're encrypted and they have been crypto lockered and it was not their fault. It was actually the people they paid to protect them. That's where things get really scary. So it's going to destroy this company undoubtedly. Even if they have cybersecurity insurance, their survivability is low. So think about that as you're building out your MSP. Start security from day one. By the time you grow the company and you've made these clear rules of everyone has to have it, your life will be better. I'll leave links to this, as I said, and stay secure. All right, thanks. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to subscribe to this channel to see more content, hit that subscribe button and the bell icon, and maybe YouTube will send you a notice when we post. If you want to hire us for a project that you've seen or discussed in this video, head over to lawrencesystems.com, where we offer both business IT services and consulting services, and are excited to help you with whatever project you want to throw at us. Also, if you want to carry on the discussion further, head over to forums.lawrencesystems.com, where we can keep the conversation going. And if you want to help the channel out in other ways, we offer affiliate links below, which offer discounts for you and a small cut for us that does help fund this channel. And once again, thanks again for watching this video, and see you on next time.